Tonight, Republican Congressman Louie Gohmert of Texas, positive for coronavirus, getting not on Air Force One because he was found out just before he was to be with the president. He says he may have gotten it by wearing a mask.
I can't help but think that if I hadn't been wearing a mask so much in the last 10 days or so, I really wonder if I would have gotten it. But I know, you know, moving the mask around, getting just right, I'm bound to put some virus on the mask that I sucked in. That's most likely what happened.
Out front now, Professor Erin Bromage. He teaches biology at the University of Massachusetts, Dartmouth, and is a CNN contributor. And I'm glad to have you with me tonight, Professor. So Gohmert repeatedly floating this idea that he, who, of course, we've seen him in public many times, very rarely wears masks to begin with, that he actually contracted the virus by wearing one. How likely is that?
Well, thanks for having me on tonight, Erin. I have to admit, that's one of the silliest, the dumbest things I've heard, all week. That's not the way that it works. If anything, his mask saved him from getting a higher dose of the virus, if that's truly what actually happened.
Wow, it's just, it's just pretty incredible that he would even put something like that out there. I mean, we do, to my point, right, he doesn't like to wear a mask anyway, and he's been saying they don't work. So he didn't wear a mask around other people. Yesterday, he was with the Attorney General, Bill Barr. He was not wearing a mask. He was not wearing a mask when he was talking to Congressman Doug Collins before yesterday's hearing in the Judicial Committee. You can see he pulled his, and then Collins then pulled his mask down to talk to Gohmert as well. Right. So there's that. When he does have a face covering, like in yesterday's hearing with Barr, although he's not wearing it at the moment we're showing here, he wears a bandana, usually not over his mouth or his nose. So when our reporter Manu Raju asked him why he wasn't wearing a mask on the House floor last month, he said, and I want to quote the congressman to you, Professor, "I don't have the coronavirus. Turns out, as of yesterday, I've never had it. But if I get it, you'll never see me without a mask." Okay, what's wrong with that logic?
In order for him to get the coronavirus, he has been around people. He's been having the interactions that we've been saying for 6 months that we cannot have, especially in indoor environments. He has gone for the last 4 months without a mask as he's walked around Capitol Hill, around his fully staffed office, having the interactions to show Americans how to reopen safely. Well, that experiment has really played out, and it's quite obvious now. You cannot have a fully staffed office and expect not to get infected by coronavirus inside that space.
So you mentioned his staff. I'm sorry to jump in on you, Professor, but one member of his staff told Politico that the Congressman Gohmert would berate them for wearing masks. He wanted every member of his staff in the office to show what reopening looked like. So he said they all had to come in, and he would berate them for wearing a mask. So I guess, first of all, how far could the spread be? But also, what's your feelings about somebody who would say that and do that?
Yeah, so unlike you and I, Congress has access to rapid testing, and they can be screened very readily for these things. And there is a chance that we've caught the infection really early, and he hasn't had a chance to spread it to others. But he obviously caught it either in his private life or in his life at work. And so really what we have to worry, if he's had people in his office, and again, a fully staffed office, and they're having interactions and he caught it from one of them, that means the rest of his staff has also been exposed. Now, if we've caught it late on him and he's actually infectious and able to infect others, then he's the one that will have spread it to his staff. So he's actually been part of the problem, part of the transmission chain. And this argument about not wearing masks and only wearing it when you're infected, you don't know. And he would not have known he was infected if he didn't have access to the resources that they've put in place for Congress.
Well, Professor, I really appreciate your time. I thank you very much. And I just want our viewers to know, the CDC director today said, we don't have to wait for a vaccine. We have the most powerful weapon in our hands right now. It is a simple, flimsy mask. This virus can be defeated if people just wear a mask. That is what you need to know. And not to listen to people who are saying complete and utter BS about the topic.